What made you want to tell this story? What excited you about it as a storyteller?
Well, it's a story which I invented and wrote, and that's what makes it exciting. I mean, it's a story, you know, it's got several elements. Well, one element is this character of Anna stroke Ida, who, you know, is a Catholic nun who discovers that she's got you know, Jewish blood in her veins, and that kind of throws her off course. It's a kind of, you know, a bit of an examination of the idea, the notion of faith and religion. Do you have to, you know, be a Polish Catholic Slav in order to be a Christian, or, you know, how deep does faith go? Is it a matter of just conventions and following the rules, or is it something that fills you up? I mean, the different sort of faith. It's a reflection on faith, identity, all sorts of things. And the other important character, Wanda, is based on somebody who I met like 20 years ago, maybe more now. I met this wonderful woman who I thought was wonderful at the time, this older woman in Oxford. She was a wife of an academic and very, very warm, witty older lady called Helena Bruzwolinska. And I remember dinners at her house. She was very, very funny, witty, didn't suffer fools gladly, told great stories, and very warm above all. And then about 10 years after I'd met her, I heard on the BBC News bulletin an item about Polish government requesting the extradition of that very lady on the grounds of crimes against humanity, because she had been in the early 50s a Stalinist state prosecutor who engineered the death of totally innocent people. So I couldn't square these two characters, you know, the woman who I met, who was very warm, wise, ironic, humane, with this woman who was once a bloody fanatic, who really was a believer. I mean, she was a genuine believer. And that kind of, that character stayed with me for years. I tried to write a different story about it. But then when I came across or invented the story of Ida, Anna, and I put it together with the story of the woman who lost her faith in Marxism-Leninism, but still faith, suddenly these two characters enhanced each other and made a good story. And that's more or less the kind of origins of the story.
Did the process of exploring these characters and telling this story change your own perspective about faith and what it means to people?
It didn't change, but it helped me think about it. No, it hasn't changed it. But, you know, but everything is there in a film. So, you know, also it's not like some intellectual exercise you do, you know, when you make a film. You know, you just make a film that has its own kind of poetics and logic and form and feeling, you know. So it wasn't an intellectual journey. It was more like a film journey.
Of course, I mean, you have two fantastic actresses in your lead roles. Can you tell us a little bit about the casting process and finding people to inhabit these characters?
Yeah, well, one of them, the lady who plays Wanda, is a virtuoso theatre actress, really, really great actress, who I've seen before and seen her in a film. And she was just a thoroughbred actress, you know. You just had to kind of work with her and channel her in some ways. The other actress who plays Ida, Anna, had never acted in her life before. I've spotted her in a cafe. And not only did she never act before, she never wanted to act, which is very rare these days, you know, for young women. So when I discovered she doesn't want to act, it kind of made me think that possibly she's the right character for this part, you know, who's something about this character of Anna is that she doesn't grimace with her face, you know. She clearly thinks, and there's something going on behind her eyes, but she doesn't do this stuff that we do in order to communicate in sort of daily life and society, you know, like pulling faces and communicating by making, you know, faces. And she had that quality, you know. She was on the one hand very bright, had a kind of very young, almost baby face, but a kind of clearly something was going on in her brain. I mean, she's a very, very bright girl. And so she was, you know, that was her first role, and she doesn't particularly want to act now either. You know, she's happy to do what she's doing, and it was just a one-off, I think.
Very happy to talk to you today. Final question, what does it mean to you to bring the film to the London Film Festival?
It's great. I'm really thrilled because it's a festival I've been somehow, you know, connected with. I've lived in London most of my life, or around London. And a lot of my friends will turn up, so it's a good excuse to catch up with friends.